أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته For those of you who are not Muslims, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. Viewers, today I'm going to be dealing with aspect of the Bible and the Quran to justify what we've been saying for quite a long time, almost 1,400 years ago, that the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is indeed the Messenger of Allah sent to guide mankind after Allah have sent series of messengers. Before then, there is one Quranic verse that Allah said, "Inna awkhayna ilayka kama awkhayna ila Nuhin wa nabiyyina min qablik wa awkhayna ila Ibrahima wa Ismaila wa Ishaqa wa Ya'qub wal Asbab wa Isa wa Ayuba wa Yunus wa Harun wa Sulaiman." To the end of the verse. What the verse is saying is that we, God Almighty speaking here, he said, we are the one that sent inspiration unto you, O Muhammad, just like we sent it to Nuh or Noah or Ibrahim and Ishmael and Isaac and Jacob and Jesus and Job and Suleiman and all these prophets. To the end of the verse. So in the Quran or in Islamic teaching, each and every nation, Allah have sent a messenger. وَلَكَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا To each and every community, a messenger have passed through them. The Quran is still teaching this, that each and every messenger of Allah came to present to mankind the monotheistic way of life. And that is exactly what Islam has been saying. As a matter of fact, I don't think there's any religion today that establishes itself as a monotheistic religion following the law and the dictates sent by Allah to that to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, following that which Abraham have brought. And we've been saying this for quite a long time, and I've been having discussion with so many Christian brethren, but they still ask so many questions. But today, I have found one verse in the Bible. This verse is so consistent with what Muhammad have said, Jesus have said, the Quran have said, and intellectuals who have delved deep into comparative religion are saying. And that verse can be found in 1st Epistle of John, chapter 4, verse 1. It reads, and I want you to listen carefully and digress the information that this verse is talking about. It begins by saying, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try them and see if they came from God. Because there are so many false prophets that have gone into the world. The spirit that confesses that Jesus is the Messiah, that spirit is a good prophet." Do you hear what I said? I'm going to read again. "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try them and see if they came from God. Because there are so many false prophets that have gone into the world." Now, here in this verse is using spirit and prophet synonymously. "Beloved, believe not every spirit, because there are so many false prophets that have gone into the world." So this verse is saying that a good spirit is a good prophet. A bad spirit is a bad prophet. But at the end, the verse said, the spirit or the prophet that confesses that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, that spirit or that prophet is a true prophet. And the question is, after Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, left the earth, the only prophet that came and spoke to the world, one third of the world are convinced at the behest of that which the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have said, that Jesus Christ is the Messiah. And the Bible said, whosoever come, the prophet that come and confess that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, that prophet is a true spirit and is a true prophet. Did Muhammad say he is the Messiah? Did Muhammad say Abu Bakr is the Messiah? Did he say Umar is the Messiah? Or did Muhammad say Uthman or Ali are the Messiah? No. The Quran said, "Innamal Masih Isa ibn Maryam Rasulullah." Most certainly the Messiah, Jesus Christ, the son of Mary, is a messenger of Allah. The Quran also said, "Mal Masihu Isa ibn Maryam Rasulullah. Mal Masihu Isa ibn Maryam Rasulullah. Kad halat min qablu rusul wa ummuhu siddiqa." Most certainly, Jesus Christ, the Messiah, the son of Mary, is a messenger of Allah. And that John, 1 John chapter 4 verse 1 is confirming what the Quran have said. Because the Quran have said, "Wa anzalna alayka al-kitaba bil haqq مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيِّ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. We send down to you, O Muhammad, in truth, confirming that which we have given the other prophet. So, 1 John chapter 4 verse 1 is confirming what Allah had given to Muhammad, that whosoever came or come after Jesus Christ and claim that Jesus is the Messiah, that prophet or that spirit is the true prophet. Because in John chapter 3 verse 6, we found this word, a true spirit, a good spirit, confirm good spirit. And bad spirit is fleshy. So Muhammad here is a true spirit. If you go to Medina today in Saudi Arabia, at the tomb of Muhammad Sallallahu it is written, La ilaha illallah, al-malik al-haqqum mubin, Muhammad Rasulullah, as-saduq al-wa'd al-ameen. The truthful, the spirit, the truth, that is Muhammad. This name was given to him by his enemies long before he was commissioned to become the messenger of Allah. So this is just a short video trying to confirm 1 John chapter 4 verse 1 and corroborate with the word of the Quran, what Allah have said, inconsistent and with reasonable, you know, edification, that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is indeed the messenger of Allah sent to guide mankind. Hazza billahi tawfiq. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
سبيل مريح تنهدى يا صاحي كي تستريح.